The Palestinian Authority deployed security forces to confront protesters who took to the streets after one of President Mahmoud Abbas's biggest critics died in custody. More in this report.
There have been several days of protests in the occupied West Bank following the death in custody of a prominent critic of President Mahmoud Abbas. Palestinian security officers have clashed with protesters who have marched through Hebron and Ramallah. The family of the activist, Nizar Banat, says Palestinian Authority forces broke into a relative's house where he had been staying in the early hours of Thursday and beat him with a metal rod before arresting him. He later died. Banat had accused Abbas's PA of corruption, including over a short-lived COVID vaccine exchange with Israel and Abbas's postponement of a long-delayed election in May. He had registered as a candidate for parliament in the race. The PA security services say they're investigating the death, but protesters like Ismat Mansour want the inquiry to be led by someone else.
The killing of Banat is the tip of the iceberg. It hides a mountain of corruption and the absence of elected organizations. We want total political reform.
Rights groups say Abbas regularly arrests critics, and Human Rights Watch said the arrest was no anomaly. Abbas and the PA have rejected accusations of corruption and that they arrest people for their political views.
News overseas now. An American journalist deported by Myanmar claims to have been tortured while in detention. Nathan Mong, editor-in-chief of online news platform Kamayat Media, says security forces beat him and kept him blindfolded for more than a week of interrogation. He also says a colleague who remains in detention has been tortured more harshly, along with other people he met in prison. Mong's claims echoes those of thousands of others since the army overthrew the government in February. But the junta has insisted detainees are being treated in accordance with the law. Before and after videos show North Korean leader Kim Jong-un has noticeably lost weight over a span of weeks, and his countrymen are getting worried. This report.
North Korea's leader Kim Jong-un is apparently losing weight so quickly that people in that country are worried for him. That's according to North Korea's tightly controlled media, and before and after videos compiled by Reuters do show he seems to be noticeably thinner. For example, earlier this month, North Korean TV aired footage of Kim attending a party meeting, but a different video that's said to be from only about 4 months earlier in February and is shot from the same angles shows a different figure. Foreign analysts had noticed the change several weeks ago, and on Sunday, North Korean TV did a rare segment on Kim's health. It broadcast video of North Koreans watching Kim on television. This man, said to be a Pyongyang resident, is saying that the leader looks emaciated and that it breaks the people's hearts. It's not clear why Kim may have lost weight, and the report didn't offer any details.
The death toll in that building collapse in Florida climbs to 9. 4 more bodies were pulled out from the rubble overnight. Search and rescue efforts continue for the more than 150 people still missing, but hopes are fading of finding survivors more than 3 days after the building gave way. The cause of the collapse is still under investigation.